Awesome. Hey, everybody. Let's get excited. This is a virtual masterclass. Isn't it amazing that you can sit right at home and get these phenomenal nuggets, this phenomenal information to apply to your life? This masterclass is just on imagining yourself having a better life. How many of us just wish when we wake up in the morning that one day it'll just be different? Look, you don't have to hope for it at all. I'm going to give you the tools. Living your best life, please understand that it is intentional. It is not going to happen one day, by and by, high in the sky. No. There are principles behind how you can apply your life to live your best life. And get excited that I'm going to give it to you today. 25 years of experience you are getting right now. So let's get right into it. I'm going to start with the slides. And guys, I'm just telling y'all right now, I am so fired up today because I'm so excited about implementing every single thing that I show you. The teacher teaches herself first, right? Before she gives it out. So when I tell you, whoop, I'm excited. So let's go ahead and get started with sharing our screen. And again, this is intellectual property, and I give you 100% access to share, to go ahead and copy anything. If you're using it to bless your life, implement great things to improve your life and improve others, you have my permission. Please take this information and share it with someone else. I invite you to do that. So right now I'm going to share the screen and get started with the presentation. And okay, there we are. So excited. I love when it works out. Yes. Awesome. If you guys can give me a thumbs up if you see the screen where it says virtual. All right, we are going to get started right now. Welcome. I won't do individual shout outs today, but I want each and every one of you to know that you are more than welcome. I'm excited to have you here. I'm beyond excited to have you here. Just so thankful for you guys. So let's get right into it. So today is our part one of our virtual masterclass. Now let's see here. Let's go right here. Awesome. Now, I want to start off by giving you the agenda. First, we're going to have our welcome introduction. Part two is how to survive difficult times. Part three, five areas of development. Part four, and I promise you, this is the part that you came for, your formula. And part five, make sure you stay to the end because we're going to have free gifts for each and every one of you at the conclusion of our meeting. So with that being said, let's go ahead and, oh, my welcome. So for those of you all who don't know me, my name is Dr. Manifa Jones. I'm a master's level psychologist. In addition to that, I'm a business owner. I do business consultations, have a plethora of experience with mental health. I have over 25 years experience of working through all of these programs. I'm a motivational speaker. I was a college professor. I taught intro to psychology, developmental psychology. So I love to teach. I've volunteered for decades in the ministry. I've always volunteered in the ministry. So I come with a lot of information, but what I want you to know and hear me loud and clear. I have no intentions to give you my background that, you know, I graduated from Western, I went to Coppin, then I went to Morgan, I went to Journal, I went to, you know, just give you all of, no. This is what I want you to know, that I've graduated from Life 101, okay? It's called the School of Life. I want you to know that most of the things that I've learned, I did not learn in a classroom. I'm gonna just be honest with you. I feel like I got bamboozled with that degree that I owed them for, right? Because most of the things that I learned, I got in the field with experience. So here we go. All right, so let's get started. Part one, how to survive difficult times. Now, there are going to be several components to this. When we were talking about promoting for this masterclass, we said COVID-19 has taken us for a loop. And so now it is time to regroup, right? We can all agree. I don't know about you guys, but I'm going to say this as a clinician, as a mother, as a psychologist, as a daughter, as a sister, I was taken for a loop. So many things happened within my family that was the unknown that I was not used to, not used to not being able to go outside and not used to not having all of the things and the supplies of water and tissue. Like, when did that change? Not being able to go to church, not being able to go to work, not being able to see my family. Like, that was a rocky time for me. And so I want everyone to know that, you know, we're on the other side, although we're still in the midst of it globally, but there are clear tools on how we can survive difficult times. So we're going to start with number one. Number one, understand that things will change. One thing we have to understand, and even though I'm talking about COVID, I'm also talking about anything you have dealt with in your life, whether it be past, current, or future, how to survive difficult times, that you can apply these principles to how to survive difficult times. If we understand, things will change. The summer will not be here always. It will not always be winter. It will not always be fall, but I promise you, things will change. Just as there are seasons in life with the weather, there are also seasons in life with us. And we have to be super clear that what goes up must come down and what goes down must go up. So don't think you're always going to be down. And don't think that it will stay that way forever. Has anybody ever experienced anything in their life and they felt like this is it? This is the thing that's going to take me out of here. Like, this is more than I can deal with. I think I've said that about 20 times in my life. I was like, I can't deal with this. I lost a son. And I said, oh my God, my son died. How do I survive this? I can't make it, God. And then my second son died. And I said it again. I said, I don't think I can make it through this one. And I can tell you thing after thing after thing that I have been through. And I said, I don't know if I'm going to make it. But please understand me, guys. Just know, no matter how you feel, just know that things will change. And I'm sure you can agree with that. Number two, how to survive difficult times. What you are going through is a necessary step. So many of us go through things, and when we get to the other side, we say, ah, I had my aha moment. I now understand why I went through what I went through. Now I get it. Now I get it, because as a result of going through that, now I understand this. As a result of going through this, now I understand that. The reason why I put a beautiful butterfly there is because in order for that butterfly to become as amazing, as beautiful as it looks on this page, guess what, guys? It had to go through a process. And if we already know in advance that life is just a series of processes, and all we have to do is be strong enough, to be cultured enough, to you know, when you know somebody's about to hit you, do you brace yourself or do you just sit there and let them slap you? If you know you're about to get a hit, do you brace yourself? Of course you brace yourself, because you understand that something is about to happen. So if we are clear that what we are going through is a necessary step of life, do we think that we'll just see it just a little bit differently? That we won't see it as, oh my God, this is a horrible surprise. This is a shock. I have people, I'm telling you, I have family members. If I call them, they'd be like, oh my God, what's wrong? What's wrong? And I was like, I just call and say hi. People automatically assume something is wrong. People automatically wait for life to happen in a negative way. But if we understand that it's a necessary step, we're going to go through some processes. Everything is not going to be perfect. Am I the only one that's been through seasons in my life where it was good and then it wasn't so good? But then the not so good actually turned out to be the thing that made my good better. Because guess what? What didn't kill me made me stronger. I got stronger as a result. And so the next time the blow came, I said, I can make it through this. The next time I had death in my family, I said, when I lost my son, I thought the sun would never shine again. I was on my way to go back to work. And at the time, I'm a young girl. I didn't have a car. And when I went to the job, the man who was interviewing me when I lost my son, he said, ma'am, it looks like you're going to do great with this job. And I thought it's time for me to go back to work. 6 months after my son died, I said, it's time for me to pull myself together. I go to the interview and he says, hey, ma'am, do you have any children? I broke down in his office, cried like a baby. I said, I don't know. Am I a mother? I do have children, but he's gone, but I don't know, sir. And I just broke down. He had to have security remove me from his office. The job that he gave me, he took back because obviously I wasn't ready. I went to go home. I'm on the subway. I had to catch a train to get home because I didn't have a car. And I decided while I was walking down the street, it was raining that day. I said, I'm not even going to put my umbrella up because I'm crying. And then people will know I'm crying. So I'm going to just act like I'm wet. How about everybody knew I was crying? Everybody's, ma'am, you okay? You okay? And as God had it, one of my church members picked me up. And they said, what are you doing standing out here in the rain crying? I was like, he just asked me, was I mother? I just didn't know. I just didn't know. But guess what? I had a friend who lost her child and she was in the hospital. And I felt spirit say, go check on her. Go check on her. I went to the hospital. And when I found her at 2-3 o'clock in the morning, she was in her bathroom, in her hospital room, on the floor, almost dead because she tried to commit suicide. She said, I had a son. He died. I cannot live. And I told her, yes, you can. She said, how do you know? Because I did. I know it. I know you're going to make it through this. I know it's going to be tough, but I know you're going to make it through this. Do you understand that difficult times prepare you for difficult times? What you're going through is a necessary process in your life. So once we learn to embrace that thing, and then now, guess what? You know how many people I've helped who told me they can't go on? And I said, yes, you can, because I'm a testimony that you can. Number three, how to survive difficult times. Look from a positive point of view. Look, you can, it depends on your perspective. Understand that you can see it as rain or you can see it as liquid sunshine. You can say, oh my goodness, it's raining today. You could say, oh my God, it's raining. I'm going to get wet. I'm going to have to put you in my windshield wipers. Oh my God, then I'm going to have to change my shoes. Or you could say, you know what? Look at all that liquid sunshine. If it wasn't for the rain, I wouldn't appreciate the sunshine. If it wasn't for the rain, I wouldn't be able to take a shower. If it wasn't for the rain, I wouldn't have all this fruit and vegetables. Oh, thank God for the rain. But you know what people do? When the rain comes, they curse the rain. They curse the rain. If you know the rain is coming, why wouldn't you just get an umbrella? Hello. Can I just explain something to you? It's going to rain. Listen, it's going to rain. I'm telling you right now, it's going to rain. So why don't you just have an umbrella rather than curse what's going to come? You will have obstacles. You will have difficulties. You will have challenges. Get your umbrella. Because it's coming. Number four, understand there are no failures in life. I'm talking about none. There's only feedback. This is another way you look at things. There are no failures, only feedback. So basically what that means is that failure is success in progress. Now, people understand that we went through COVID, people's finances changed, people's homes changed, people's relationships changed. Do you understand that that was just giving you feedback? If you hit difficult times and you didn't have enough savings for your family, do you understand that that was just feedback that you need to get some savings? If you hit difficult times and you noticed your relationships weren't intact as you thought they were, because now y'all under the same roof, for not 24 hours, but 48 hours, but 72 hours, but months, y'all under the same roof. And whereas before everybody was gone and you might come home, you might see them in the kitchen, you might not, but now you're stuck and then you're gonna label it as a failure? No, 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 no. It's not a failure. It's feedback. It's you saying, okay, this is what I'm gonna do. I'm going to analyze my situation. I feel like I failed because I don't have enough finances. Okay, that's feedback that I need to get my finances in place. I feel like I failed because my relationship is not as strong as I thought it was. Oh, that's feedback that I need to give more time to succeeding in my relationship. Do you understand that attention goes where manifestation grows? If you do not put your intention on something, it will fall apart. So when you get that feedback in your life, don't take it as a negative thing. Take it as failure is success in progress. Because listen, a lot of times failures teach you way more than success will. Because when you have success, you know what you do? You go celebrate. But for failure, it makes you think. It makes you contemplate. It makes you reconsider. It makes you analyze. Failures are good. So what if every time in our lives we got this feedback, we were like, oh, no, that's not a failure. That's just feedback. That's just showing me what to do. Number five, focus on what you can control. Focus on what you can control. Now listen, in surviving difficult times, most times people focus on what they cannot control. I cannot tell you how many people I had to block during COVID. I cannot tell you how many people I could not be in communication with because they had their TV looped on CNN all day. And they wanted to talk to me about the global challenge going on all around the world. And did you hear about this happening? Did you hear about that happening? Well, most of the media is false information anyway. But people were so engulfed and so tuned in. And guess what they were focusing on? They were focusing on that there was a pandemic. They were focusing on the fact that there was a global challenge that we were having. They were focusing on the fact that they couldn't go to work. They were focusing on the fact that we had limited supplies. Could you control how many packs of paper towels when I went to Sam's Club and I had to stand in line outside for 2 hours before I got inside? And then when I got inside and went shopping, they told me I could only get one roll of toilet paper, one box of toilet paper, one box of tissue, one water. So I stood outside for 2 hours. And then I was limited to one item for my whole family. And then I stood inside for 2 hours in the line. Do you know that? Can I control that? Can I control the fact that they were limiting the supplies I could purchase? Focus on what you can control, not what you can't. You always have to find solutions. So let me tell y'all what I did. I was like, okay, I only can get one. And I don't care what you say, you call integrity, lack of integrity. Look, I said, look, hubby, you got to go. Daughter, everybody got to go. And this is what we're going to do. We all get in individual carts and we're going to multiply how many people we got in this family. And I'm going to put all mine in your cart, your cart, your cart. Now we got five of each items. We're going to stand in this line. I found a solution. We're going to buy this, right? And then guess what we're going to do? We're going to go to the car. We're going to load up the car. And then guess what we're going to do? We're going to come back inside and do it all over again. And we're going to go get in a different cashier line. You standing up there crying about, they only won't let me have no tissue. I'm using towels and socks, and tissue costs $45 on Amazon. It takes 3 weeks to get it delivered. Jesus, what I'm going to do? I'm focusing on a solution. I was like, everybody, get up. Get out the bed. Get in the car. I need some stuff. And I got, where they said one, I got 10. Because I took five people. We filled up the car. Filled up the car, filled up the car, filled up the car. I got 10. Okay, you think I'm concerned about your thoughts about me? I'm not. I bet you I found a solution for my family. So look, don't focus on what you can't control. We can't control the government. We can't control global society. We can only control our mindset and how we respond to things. Because when you put things outside of yourself, I promise you, as a clinician, you will stay depressed for the rest of your life when you always put blame on someone else. When you say the reason why I'm having this problem is because of the government. The reason why I'm having this problem is because of my ex-husband. The reason why I am having this problem is because of what my parents did when I was younger. The moment you give up your power and you relinquish your power, and I don't know if you know the serenity prayer that said, God, grant me the serenity to accept the things that I can change. And God grant me to the serenity to accept the things that I cannot change. But most importantly, God help me to know the difference. Do you know how much easier our lives would be if we were focused on solutions, on the things that we can control, and the things that we can't control, just leave it up? I've told my husband so many times, people say I have an infectious personality. However, I'm very excited always. And I rubbed some people the wrong way. But guess what? When I was young, I used to be a people pleaser. Now, that ain't my problem. It ain't even my business what you think about me. That's between you and you. It ain't even my business no more, okay? So my goal is, look, I'm not concerned about anything. I cannot control the way you feel about me. If you love me, welcome to the party. If you don't, exit left. That's it. There's no in between. None. And when I was younger, it's like, oh, please. Would you please like me, please? What you need me to do? You need me to give you money? You need me to give you a ride? You need me to buy you something? Oh, could you please, please? And now I'm like, see you later, baby. I can't control how you feel about me. And I'm going to be me. I'm going to stay me all day, every day. Get excited about that. Number six, please understand. The universe has a better plan for you. If you're trying to survive difficult times, if your mindset is that it's all doom and gloom, I understand why you're depressed. I understand why you are overcome with anxiety, because you have settled in your mind that there is no way that it's going to get better. But what if, just what if you woke up in the morning with the mindset that I know this ain't it. So you telling me that God blessed me to be born in this beautiful earth and that this is it. So I was born to live in misery. So let me ask you this question. Oh goodness, let me ask you this question. Anybody on here parent other than me? Anybody a mama or a dad? All right, I'm a parent. Do your children rub you the wrong way? Okay, I'm the only one that say yes. Do your children get on your nerves sometimes? Do they make decisions that you don't agree with sometimes? But did you ever, one time, stop having unconditional love for them? Did you? Okay, so I'm gonna say badass kids, right? You didn't stop ever stop having love for them. And you gave them unconditional love. And let me tell you something I realized being a mama of three sons. Let me tell you what I realized. My greatest joys, I'm talking about my greatest joys on this planet, came from my sons. That's my heart, my soul, my boys, born from my belly, came from my sons. I wish I had all five, but thank God I had three. But let me tell you something. I ain't never been hurt like I've been hurt from my sons. Because guess what? Look, you can't do nothing to me. All I'm going to say is I had a friend. I don't have a friend. But it's different when you gave birth to them. It's a whole different category. When they cross you, when if a friend, you know, I had a best friend that stabbed me in the back. Yeah, did it hurt? Oh, yeah. Did I cry? Yeah. Did I miss her? Yeah. But when your child, Jesus. When it comes from the child that you did everything for, that you sacrificed for, you're like, whoa, what is happening? But at the end of the day, do I still pray for him every day? You better believe it, because I have unconditional love for him. So let me get this straight. So you think you living in this earth, you living worldly, you being a human being, that you have unconditional love for your child, right? who has done wrong, but in our eyesight, we know they can't do no wrong. We always going to love them. I don't care what they do. You murder somebody, let me hide the weapon. Like, I got you. So you think the universe don't have a better plan for you. You love your child unconditionally, but you don't think God loves you. So you think that you were born to suffer. And you said, nah, I can't survive difficult times. Not me. Why not you? Please understand the universe has a better plan for you. Please understand that everything is not by chance. Please understand that everything is a process leading to the next step in your life. If we understood that, every time something came, we wouldn't be shocked. We wouldn't be surprised. And then in the aftermath, we wouldn't be bitter. We wouldn't say, I cannot believe this happened to me. Instead, we would say, this happened for me. Because when my best friend stabbed me in the back, now I know what to look for in best friends. And when my ex-husband was a womanizer and was not a good man, now I know what to look for in a man. You just showed me what I don't want. You just basically gave me the master plan and a blueprint for what I don't want. So I celebrate you. I welcome you for everything that you taught me. Understand, the universe has a better plan for you. You are not born to suffer. If you believe that, you're on punishment right now. You were not born to suffer. You were not brought here to this life to just be born and to be abused as a child and to never find your way financially as an adult and to never blossom in your relationships and never blossom in financial prosperity and never have a progressive life. That is not the plan. But you don't understand that you are the manifester. You are the creator. Everything you see is a reflection of what you have created. And if you don't like what you have created, let's create different. Let's find a better way. Let's figure out how we are going to create something different because we know that there is a better plan. We know that the plan was not to suffer all the days of our life. The plan was not to wake up every morning and just go ahead and let's remember the misery from yesterday. My memories of my miseries. Let me go ahead and stroke my pain. Let me go ahead and stroke my diseases. Let me go ahead and stroke my disappointments. Guys, we have to discipline our disappointments. It's not what you think it is. It's for you. It's not happening to you. It's happening for you. You understand that it's just feedback. Letting you know that there is a better way. Letting you know that there isn't another way. But see, this is the thing. It's easy. But guess what? It's easier not to do. It's easier to wake up and not be there for yourself. It's easier to not trust yourself. It's easier to not make yourself accountable. It's easier to say, I need to exercise, but I'm not going to. It's easier to say, I need to eat cleaner, but I'm not going to. And then you get a disease and you say, oh God, you have cursed me because I have high blood pressure. What? No. You curse yourself with all the potato chips and ice cream. Don't say God did that. God didn't do that. Did God tell you eat all that pork? No. So we have to take responsibility. Number 7. Woo, this is my favorite one. Woo. Reignite your motivation. How to survive difficult times. You know what? We forget who we are. We knew when we had that time when we felt good about ourselves and we felt excited about life. What did that look like? Go back and journal. I don't know if you were 16, if you were 12, if you were 25 or 45, but remember a time in your life when you liked yourself. And if you never have, call me for life coaching. I'll help you with that. Remember a time when you liked yourself and you were like, my body looked good. I felt good about myself. I had a pep in my step, you know? And then what happens? Life happens. Oh my God. Life just happens. We tell ourselves, I can't believe my bank account looked the way it do. I'm going to be happy when I have this much money in the bank. I don't believe I'm single. I'm going to be happy when I have a spouse. I don't believe I'm still living in this zip code. I've been said I was going to move away from this place. I don't believe I'm still driving this car. I don't believe, I don't believe, I don't believe, I don't believe. And then guess what? We stop showing up for ourselves and we don't trust ourselves. And when we stop trusting ourselves, guess what? We don't try no more. What makes you think you did already? Look, if you on this, you on this webinar, you breathing, will you please notify yourself that you're still here? And as long as you're still here, don't you know that you can reignite your motivation? Don't you know that you can reinvent yourself? I don't care what you've been through. I don't care what it looks like. Don't you know in 24 hours, your whole situation can turn around just by your mindset? Reignite your motivation. Say, remember who you are. Look in the mirror. Say your affirmation and say, oh, I'm a bad mama jamma. I ain't going out like this. Ain't no way in the world I was born to live a mundane life. Ain't no way in the world I was born to live a mediocre life. Nah, that's for those low frequency people. That ain't for me. Reignite your motivation, whatever that takes. I did a virtual vision board party, which I'm going to tell you guys about. If you join that class, you'll be able to reignite your motivation. Number 8, step out and look from a third party perspective. Most people have pity parties. And most people think about all the things that are going wrong instead of thinking about what's going right. You know how you survive a difficult time? By literally looking at it as an outsider. We went through COVID-19, our finances changed, a lot of things changed. But when you look at it from the outside, my husband and I, we became very grateful, very thankful. I started seeing the way the pandemic affected other parts of the world. I started seeing the way people were being policed. People were being forced to have injections. People were being, like, I had to look at it from a different way and say, we're okay. And instead of focusing, look, what is going on in your life right now that you feel like, man, this is tough. This is so hard, God. How do I get through this? Step out. Sometimes you literally have to leave your house. Leave it. Leave the, stop that perspective you're looking at. You're looking at the same TV, the same sofa. You're looking at the same kitchen. You're looking at the same man. And you're like, Jesus, this is a bad picture. Sometimes leave that environment. My husband and I, we go on destiny dates and dream dates. We go and look at million-dollar mansions. We go, he wants a Tesla car. We go test drive. If we're constantly looking at what we don't want, we're going to keep getting what we don't want. Sometimes you have to look from another perspective. Sometimes you do have to go to the mountaintop and look down and realize that from our point of view, the way we're looking at it, do you know that if you're looking straight at something, let me tell you, to this day, I don't understand how my grandmother hosted Thanksgiving in New York, East River Projects, Harlem, Manhattan, in my grandmother's house with 2-bedroom apartment. The living room, the kitchen was side by side, the kitchen and 2 bedrooms and a bathroom. Do you know our whole family was there? It was like 50, 60 of us. When I was a little girl and I used to go to grandma's house for Thanksgiving in New York, and as soon as we went down East Harlem Drive, we're like, oh, we're getting close to grandma's house. East River Projects, we're getting close. We would get so excited when we get off on 3rd Avenue and go to grandma's house. And as a little girl, it looked like a mansion to me. My whole family was there. We had fun. We slept on the floor. And when I became adult and I went back to the house, I said, how in the world? It's another perspective. I wasn't a little girl anymore. Now I'm this tall, big adult. I said, how in the world did we get in this 2x4? But it looked so big to me as a little girl. Listen, guys, sometimes you have to see it from another perspective. It will make you thankful, I promise you. If you stop focusing on all the things that are going right and think about what is going well, if you stop focusing on all the things that are not going right but focusing on the one or two or three things that are going well, guys, it's going to make a difference. Number nine, realize that you're not alone. Please realize you're not alone. I can't tell you how many clients told me, Dr. J, I don't have nobody. All I have is you. I don't have nobody. I beg to differ. I don't know your faith, and I'm not here to preach to you. But if you really think you don't got through this universe by yourself, my personal opinion, you're a dangerous person. If you really think you so bad to the bone that you help yourself to breathe every day, you so bad to the bone that you helping that heart beat every day, you so bad to the bone that you got that liver, you got that liver working good, don't you? You got that kidney. Who you think? Ooh, don't get me started. Who do you think was so smart to put our ears right here so we can put our glasses? Now I'm just, it's crazy, right? Who was so amazing to put the arms and the legs and when a man looks at the woman, he's like, whoa, man, who made all that? Like, you really thought you did that? You really thought you were that bad? I don't think so. You're not alone. You can celebrate that right here forever and ever. Amen. You're not alone. If you ever sit by yourself and meditate, you look, you're not alone. Have you ever had any victories in your life? You ain't do that by yourself. You ever been down and you said, I'm always by myself? You thought you were by yourself. How you think you got through it? How you think you got through it? Let me tell you something. When my son died, I went to church. I was so mad. I was so mad at God. I said, God, I can't believe you did this to me. You're a mean God. You're a horrible God. And it's the last time I'm coming to church. And I walked in church and I said, I'm not going in a sanctuary because you took my son from me. I refuse to go in a sanctuary. I am going to go up on a balcony and sit in this church. And this is the last time I'm coming in here because you took my son from me. And God, I think I hate you. That's what I said. I went up to the balcony of the church. And a pastor came up and he said, and I said, God got a sense of humor. So you know what the pastor says? If you go to the heights of the heaven, I am there. And if you go to the depths of hell, I am there. I was like, oh my God, did the pastor just hear what I said? Did the pastor hear me? He said, I don't care. You can't. He said, you can't escape me. It was like God was talking straight to me. And I cried. And I cried like a baby. And I sat up on that balcony. I cried like a baby. And I said, but God, you don't understand. I lost my son. And God was like, also, I don't understand that you lost the. Let me tell you something about Calvary, girl. Come here. You, I don't understand that you lost the son. What did you say to me? Do you know my son died on Calvary? What are you saying? I was like, oh, I'm sorry. Maybe you do understand. I'm sorry. And then I said, well, God, you understand you lost the son, but you don't have feelings. This pain I'm feeling right now, you can't even wrap your arms around me. You can't even help me. This little boy came up to the balcony. He's a pastor today, by the way. And I believe he heard from God. This little boy, he was like 3-4 years old. He came up to the balcony. And he said, God told me to hug you. These his arms. I said, what you say, boy? I said, what you say? He said, I gotta hug you. God said, hug you. These his arms. I was like, oh my God, what is happening? Needless to say, I went back to church. I said that was gonna be my last day. But I went back. Please mute yourself for the integrity of the call. I went back though. Come on now, you're not alone. I know we think we crafty. I know we think we bright. I know we think we smart. I know we think we know how to do stuff. Look. Show me right now. Show me how you put your limbs together. God said he knows how many hairs is on your head. Do you know how many hairs is on your head? He said he knows you from the crown of your head to the sole of your feet. Do you even know? You're not alone. Number 10. Uh-oh, that was a mistake. Oh, I think I lost it, but we're going to go back. I was getting so excited. Number 10, like I said, I don't know what your faith is, but in difficult times, meditate. Just sit still, pray, have faith. Man, we got prayer twisted, man. Prayer ain't talking all the time. Prayer ain't no to-do list for God. Prayer ain't no, can you do this? Can you do this? Can you do this? Can you do this? I need help with my bills. I need help with my life bills. I need help with my son. Can you fix this? Can you? Nah, man. Sometimes you got to be quiet. Sometimes you got to shut your mouth. Sometimes you have to say, here am I, use me. Like, what am I supposed to be giving to you? For my whole life, I've asked you to give and give and give and give and give. Do you understand that any relationship that doesn't have proper reciprocity, a give and a take, it is an unbalanced situation. It always, let me tell you something in case you never heard it before. In order for relationships to be balanced, it must be give and give. What are you giving? When did we have a shopping list for God? When did we have a to-do list for God? When did we have a honey-do list for God? Yes, he said, depend on me. Yes, he said, call upon me. But when did he say, just tell me, boom, 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 and you don't never listen? You don't never sit still? You don't never seek his face? But you're expecting everything to be amazing? Man. I think we got this twisted, guys. I don't know what your faith is, but if you don't do anything else, I always say, if you don't have 5 minutes, you don't have a life. Steal away. Give yourself bare bone minimum 5 minutes and then work it up. Like, sit still. It's okay to be quiet. It's okay, I promise you. 2 minutes is gonna feel like an eternity if you've never done it before. You know, start small. But just sit for 5 minutes and don't say anything. It's going to seem crazy at first, right? But do it. Don't say anything. Just sit. And guess what you'll realize? You don't have to call your best friend. You don't have to call your mama. You don't have to call your pastor. You don't have to call your grandmama. You don't have to call your girlfriend, your boyfriend, your lover. You don't have to call nobody, because the moment you sit still, you're going to realize all the power resides in you anyway. You're going to realize that all the answers reside in you. You're so busy talking, telling God what to do. You're so busy begging your friends for their opinion, and they don't even know what to do with their life. You're so busy. Pastor, please pray for me. My sister told me, she was over at my house a couple days ago, and she said her pastor gave her the permission to stop praying for people. If they come into 2 years, you on the altar, we still praying about the same thing from years ago? Like, come on now, let's do something different. So get excited. So this is the next thing, part two. Five focus areas to develop. Now, this was covered in my virtual vision board party, which I'm going to invite you to actually have a copy. But let's go over it briefly. There are five areas in your life that if you spent all of 2022 getting yourself right in these areas, I mean, spend all, and I'm in 2022, by the way, starts now. If you spent all of next year saying my spiritual development is going to be at a level that I can be proud of, my personal development, my mindset, my emotional development, how I manage my emotions. I'm 52 years old and I still get angry and I still fly off at people and I still flip out on people. That's not them, that's me. There is an original hurt inside of me. There is an original hurt inside of me that's telling me that something is wrong, because when this person comes. Do you understand that when you have a wound that is not healed and somebody touch that wound, do you understand when you have a wound that is not healed and they touch it, it hurts? It's like, let it heal first. It's still tender. I'm still getting my scab. And you think you mad at your husband. You think you mad at your best friend. You think you mad at your daughter. You not. It's an original wound that has never been healed. Original wounds. We go through so much trauma in our lives. We have children who were not validated. So as adults, when they get rejected, they flip out. Because we are reminded when we were 6 years old and our mommies didn't say she was proud of us. And we think we're flipping out on that situation. No, it's the original hurt. It's the original trauma that had been reignited. Let me tell you, if you spend all of 2022, which starts now, spending 100% of your time having a 90-day challenge in all of these areas, starting with spiritual development. First thing, 90 days. Let's work on that. How do I want to show up spiritually in this world? Okay, I want to read my Bible every day. I may read it once every 6 weeks. Let's fix that. Okay, I want to be a Proverbs 31 woman. It's 31 Proverbs. Today is November 13th. I'm going to read Proverbs 13. Let's start there. I want to read my Bible every day. I want to at least meditate for 5 minutes. I want to pray. Like, I want to show up different in the world. I don't want to show up as this wounded, traumatized person. Let me tell you something. I told you our journey is a process, our failures are feedback. I told you all of that about difficult times. But if you understand with our spiritual development, I understand that we may have been raped or molested or hurt, or someone put violence against us, someone stabbed us in the back. That's one thing, right? For us to survive. But what's not okay is for you to bully yourself. What's not okay is for you to say, well, because this happened to me, I get to be this bitter, angry person. Because this happened to me, I get to show up in the world less than who I really am. I am not no mediocre, low-frequency person. Are you kidding me? I have to show up in the best way possible. And the only way you're going to show up in the best way possible is to develop all of these areas. Spiritual development. Personal development. That is reading books. You have to learn. I don't care how old you are. You have to be a perpetual student forever and ever. Amen. Get some audio books. Get some books and start reading. Watch YouTube videos. If you're a person who you understand that you're a people pleaser and you don't feel good about yourself, let's just be clear. You have low self-esteem. Self-esteem has nothing to do with nobody else, hence the word self. You have low self-esteem because you were invalidated. Look, been there, done that. I decided... It took me 5 decades to say, I'm going to validate myself. I ain't waiting. I became a doctor and I begged certain people, can you come to the hospital, please? And see my name, please. I'm a doctor. And they said, nah. And instead of me celebrating becoming a doctor, I cried like a baby for weeks because I said they wouldn't come and celebrate me. It took me 5 decades to say, guess what, girl? Celebrate yourself. We're going to celebrate you right here, right now. Guess who's invited to the party? It's 3 people on the guest list. Me, myself, and I. Hey, get excited. We are celebrating you today. I know back in the 2004, girl, you was waiting for your mama, and you was waiting for your brother, and you was waiting for you was waiting, girl. And guess what? They ain't showed up yet. What you going to do? What you going to do? I'm going to show up for myself. That's what I'm going to do. Guess what, Dr. J? Oh, girl. You did the dang thing. Get excited. It comes a time in our lives when we stop putting the power outside of ourselves. When are we going to start saying, no. You don't have the right. You don't have the right to tell me who I am. You don't have the right to tell me how far I'm going to go. And you dang sure don't have the right to put a label on me. Oh, you're an alcoholic. How you know? You with me 24/7? Look, if you tell yourself you have low self-esteem, you better fix those insecurities. You do that by showing up for yourself. And the reason why you accept that label, and the reason why you talk negatively about yourself, and the reason why you bully yourself is because you don't trust yourself. Because you don't show up for yourself. Because you set the alarm clock and you turn it off because you're like, ain't no point in getting started. My life is miserable anyway. I promise you, 2022 starts now. Take a 90-day spiritual challenge. And like, girl, open it, Bible. Next step, 90 days, personal development. We're reading some books. 90 days, physical development. We're going to start working out. I don't care if you walk to the end of the block. Move them legs, girl. Man, I used to be so lazy. Thank God I started losing weight and I'm concerned about my health. I used to be so lazy. If something was upstairs, man, I wasn't getting it till tomorrow. Tomorrow. I had to wait till I went upstairs at night. I would get it and take it back down the next day. Like, who does that? That is so lazy. Like, physical development. Let's start physically developing ourselves so if we need something, we can walk up the steps. Like, it's crazy. But see what, we're laughing and it is funny, but for real though, it ain't funny because what happens in the natural happens in the spirit. And just like I wouldn't go up, guess what? In life, I wouldn't go up. I didn't believe in myself. I had insecurities. I didn't show up for myself. So that's how I showed up in the world. I'm doing this webinar today. Do you know I could have did this webinar 10 years ago? Do you know I had the same information 10 years ago? And you know the reason why I never shared it? Because I was 330 pounds. I was 110 pounds larger. And I told myself, and nobody gonna listen to you because they gonna tell me, they gonna be like, why is she teaching us? She need to go learn how to lose weight. Ain't nobody gonna listen to you. That's what I told myself. And so I stopped myself. For 20 years, like even more, I said, no. I can't teach nobody. This is my gift, but I can't do it. What gift do you have that you holding yourself back from? That you're not putting in the earth because you told yourself the projection of what somebody else is going to say. You were given that gift freely. However, you're being selfish with it. Listen, get and focus on these areas. And that's why I said you have 100% of your time, 100% of your time to focus on this. That means you have 0% for your children's drama. Yep, I said it. You have 0% for your mans, your girlfriends, your churches. You have 0%. You're like, excuse me, I unapologetically have exited the building. I'm working on me. I got a project going on right now and I'm unavailable. And what that project is me. And guess what? It took me 52 years to figure out that I was a priority. So you're going to have to stand in line because this is my priority right now. Next thing is relational development. Look, you ain't got enough time. We ain't got enough time for the seminar to talk about the people in your life. You are the mirror image of the people in your life. When they say birds of a feather flock together, look at the people in your life. If that's not who you are, I'm just telling you, you need to separate from them. I ain't biting my tongue. I'm not going to be around a whole bunch of people that don't have no vision, that don't have no hope for the future. No. I remember when I used to live in Reisterstown, Maryland, we had a snowstorm. And I lived in an 8-bedroom mansion, 3-car garage, 7 bathrooms, beautiful home, 2 acres yard. And every single time it snowed, I live in Reisterstown, Maryland with all the Jewish people. They came up my long driveway at the cul-de-sac and they cleaned all my snow. So one day everybody's like stuck in the house and you know, all of that. So they said, let's get together and put some food and drinks together, you know, cause we've been stuck in the house. Everybody, you know, had, you know, that snow fever, they had that fever. So I went to the house, 8 adults. It was some good food though, some Jamaican food. Woo, that food was good. Some drinks, it was nice. Wine and some Jamaican food and some Jamaican music, it was good. But I had to get up out of there. because it was eight adults sitting around a table. And I live in Reisterstown, Baltimore County area. And they lived in Baltimore City. And it's not about where you live, so don't get that out of this. It's not your environment, it's your mindset. And basically what they said was, they literally complained for 2 hours straight. Oh my God, Baltimore City don't care about us. Oh my God, they won't bring a snow truck to our street. Oh my God, they are so mean to our zip code. Oh, so eight grown adults sitting around complaining that the city government didn't care enough to plow their street. They would be my friends to this day if they would have said, why don't all eight of us get some shovels and go plow the dang street? So you telling me we're going to sit here for 8 hours complaining about something that we can do something about? I'm exiting left. Y'all can't be my friends, because they asked me, and that's when I left. They said, aren't you upset about it? I said, no, my street's clear. Sorry. I ain't upset. My street's clear. I'm not saying that to be arrogant, none of that. I'm saying that we have power over who's in our life. And if you hang around a whole bunch of people who don't dream big, if you hang around a whole bunch of people who don't have a great mindset, if you hang around a whole bunch of people who are not spiritual. Now, listen, if you're trying to become physically fit and you and your girlfriends going out to eat fried chicken every day, I'm telling you right now, you're not going to get spiritually physically fit. You need to hang around somebody and say, put that chicken down. We're going to get salad today, girl. And we're going around and walk around the track. You better be careful. Also, financial development. Listen, again, we don't have enough time. What you don't focus on won't grow. We can't say it's the government. We can't say it's our job. Because what a lot of people don't understand, can I tell you how many people I've given therapy to that I kind of had to use like a gestalt therapy, it's a confrontational therapy. And like, can I be honest with you? Do you want me to play with you? Or you want me to be honest with you? And if you give me permission to be honest with you, and you're so upset about your finances, I said, let me explain something to you. How much have you sold your soul for? $10 an hour? Oh, no. You sold your soul for $20 an hour? Oh, no, you sold your soul for $30. You big time. You sold your soul for a salary, a biweekly salary of $5,000 in corporate America. You big time over there. That's what you sold your soul for? You wonder why you can't get the promotions and your job ain't working right? You ain't supposed to be there. That's why. You're supposed to be showing up as a light. You're supposed to be producing all of your gifts. You're supposed to be on your assignment. And because you're not, you keep getting the roadblock. But you won't pay attention to the signs. You keep getting the red light. You keep getting the stop sign. And you wonder why you're stuck. You don't belong there. Because guess what happened? You said you was going to go on that job for a minute and make this little money. And then you was going to get back to your God assignment. You said you was going to get back to the gift that he put in your hands. And you never did. You started when you were 16. You're like, oh, I'm going to get back to it. Or I'm going to do it on the weekends. Or I'm going to develop myself. And you 20, oh, I got to take care of these kids now. Oh, I got to pay this mortgage now. Oh, I got to pay this car now. Oh, I got to sell my soul for $30 an hour. And I got to take my children and I got to put them with strangers and let the strangers take care of them while I sell my soul for $30 an hour, because I can't trust God. No. I can't do that. I got to sell my soul. So many people, guys, they out of place. And they wonder why their money don't work. Because you don't work. You're in the wrong place. Because when you're in the right place, there's increase. When you're in the right place, there's growth. And I'm not saying you're not going to be at a standstill sometime. And sometime you have to go on a journey. I'm not saying that. But if you've been doing something for 20, 30, 40 years and it still ain't working yet, it's just not. Okay? So, 5 focus areas to develop. We have to focus on all of these areas. Now, what I'm going to tell you guys is that We had a vision board party. Get excited. We had a vision board party. Anyone who would like the recording, go ahead and send me a message. I'll have all of my platforms at the end. Send me a message. I text most of you guys today. I will send you this recording. We had a vision board party. 2022 starts now. And guess what? Next Saturday is part two of the vision board party, but that's when we actually show our vision board. But if you missed it, I will go ahead, send you the recording of our session, and then you can do the assignment. And once you do the assignment, you can come to our class next week. We talked about a vision board for all of those five areas. How do you want yourself to look spiritually in 2022? Let's put it in front of us. We talked about that amazing triangle. Vision, writing it down, and then saying it out of our mouth. Affirmation, speaking it, writing it down with our hand. Something really amazingly psychologically happens between the mind and paper, and then also visualizing it and seeing it. When you put those three things together, I told everybody I had 45 vision boards that I put up and actualized every last one of them, and I'm on 46. It works. It works. I started this when my kids were young. My oldest is 32 now. I started this when they were babies. I'm on number 46. Every time I accomplish it, I put that up, get a new one, put that up, get a new one. It works. You talking about a girl who was on welfare to real estate. You talk about a girl who was in Section 8, you know, who was on welfare. Look, had multiple degrees. Listen, you can do whatever you want to do. So if you guys want to be a part of it next week, we'll do that. Woo! Guys, that is part one and part two. We are going into our final session, part three. And I hope everybody is still awake because this is the hour I have been waiting for. The formula. Woo! This formula, I got to tell you guys, I'm so pumped and excited about this formula that, oh my Lord, this intellectual property is off the chain. All right, everybody, we're doing a quick assignment. Everybody stand up. Don't be going to sleep on me. Everybody stand up. Uh-oh. Did I move this up? I don't know how to do it. Okay, there we go. Everybody stand up. Shake yourself. We're going into the final hour. All right, everybody lift your hands up. Lift them as far as you can. Stretch your arms up. Stretch your arms up. Thank you for everybody being obedient. Stretch your arms up. Stretch your arms up. I trust that you're doing it. Now, stretch your arms as far as you can. Now, stretch them higher, higher. Thank you. Everybody shake it out and sit down for part two. If you need to get a squig of water, we in the final hour. We are on home base. This, let me tell you something. This formula. I'm just telling you. If anybody has gotten any value so far in section one and two, give me a hands up. Thank you so much. I'm excited. Yes. All right. Home stretch. Okay, I'm excited. All right. Y'all ready for the formula? Y'all ready? Okay, I can't even take it. All right. Guys, your formula is what I'm about to give you. If you pay attention to this, now this is what I'm gonna preface this by saying. I'm gonna give you a disclaimer. This is the disclaimer. What I'm about to share with you is easy to do. What I'm about to share with you is easy to do, but it's easier not to do, okay? What I'm going to give you is very basic, but let me tell you what most people do. It's not just okay, it's not good enough to have the information. You have to apply it, okay? I'm going to give you this video. I'm going to give you this slides. I'm going to give you a workbook. I'm going to give you a home assignment. If you don't, after this class, sit down and map out all the things I'm going to show you, next year, you're going to be in the same place. Spiritually, you're going to be in the same place. Physically, listen to me, all your relationships, everything is going to be at a standstill. Do you want your life to be at a standstill, or do you want to thrive? Do you want your life to like wake up in the morning, you skipping out of bed because you feel so good? You're so high off of life. You're like, I didn't know I could live where I wanted to live, drive whenever I want to drive, be in relationship with people I actually like to be around and actually do what I want. Like, I didn't know life could be this good. If you want that for yourself, listen, I just gave you an assignment. And I told everybody, I said, lift your hands up. And I said, stretch them as far as you can. And then I said, stretch them even farther. Listen, if you stretch your hands as far as they can go, it can't go anymore. That means the first time you didn't stretch them far enough. If I say stretch your arms as far as they can go, guess what? You did this. And I said, now stretch them higher. Y'all like, ooh, I got it. The first time I said as far as you can go. That's how we live our lives. We say, this is enough. This is far as I can. You know you can do better. Now, what I'm about to give you, if you see it says your, it's about you. Why is it that we give the best of ourselves to others? Why is it that we can be a great mom, a great wife, a great church member, a great employee? Why can we do that? A great sister. Why is it that we can always show up? Like my mother, let me tell you, my husband's mom, Lord Jesus, that woman, she would go to everybody funeral, everybody dinner, everybody birthday. She cook it, she take it, she just take care of everybody. How many of you guys, if somebody tell you they need you, you will drop what you're doing and help them? Listen. I wish I could knock this. Can y'all hear me? You need you, okay? Do you hear me? Do you hear me? You need you. You need you. Do this assignment. I'm going to meet you in 5 years and you're going to be in the same place. Do this assignment. It's easy to do, but it's easier not to do. If you don't give yourself the half an hour or the hour it takes to map out the formula for your life, you are doomed to depression and anxiety, because depression is rehearsing the pains of the past and anxiety is being anxious over the pains of the future, because we don't understand the unknown. And guess what most of our lives do? That's some of what people do. That's why I have a job. Because most people rehearse their past pains and plan for their future pains. That's what people do. That's how they live their lives. They don't say, I'm living my life on purpose. And by the way, you don't have a chance to mess it up. So we're not communicating because you are stressing for me, baby. I already know you don't like me. You don't treat me nice. So we can't hang out together. I love me. And you don't like me as obvious. So let's not do this. Y'all ready for your formula? Y'all ready? Y'all ready for the formula? Woo! All right, me too. All right. Your formula. Your yielding outstanding undeniable results. This is a formula for you. So what I want you to do is I want you to realize that you are the CEO of YOU. Please understand that you are the CEO of YOU. Now, most of you guys, if you're given an assignment at work, if you're given an assignment at church, most people are not rude to the point where they will not carry out the assignment. Most people will actually carry out the assignment in a great way. I know that you guys are responsible. I know that you guys operate in excellence. So now what we're about to do is put your formula together, yielding outstanding, undeniable results. Number one, first of all, you are an original. Please be clear. Please, if nobody ever told you, let me tell you today, you are the original, baby. There ain't another like you. You're the only one who had that fingerprint. You're the only one who had that smile. You're the only one walking. Come on now. You are the original. Please understand that you, look, baby girl, nobody ever told you. Let me tell you, sir, you are a very important person now. You're important. You know how I know? Because you're breathing. You're important. And if nobody told you, if you don't believe that, you better look in the mirror every day and say, you there to the bone. You VIP, girl. You the original. And authenticity, listen, authenticity is the highest frequency on this planet. People walking around trying to be like somebody else and trying to be like this person and trying to be like that person and trying to be like, no. Let me ask you a question. Anybody ever heard of the artist Michelangelo? He did some great paintings. We have so many wonderful artists. When an artist does an original painting, do we treat it differently when there's only one of a kind? Now, if they make a whole bunch of them, and that's why a lot of people, like little classy ladies, they like to shop at boutiques because it's only one of a kind. I know when I walk in the room, she ain't gonna have my dress on. But then you have some people that they have 1,000 of the same thing at Walmart. You're like, nah, I want something different for this party. Do you understand that authenticity is the highest frequency? That when you have an original, you treat it better? When you have only one of a kind, and you know, man, if I get some water on this, I can't duplicate it. I can't replicate it. It's the only one. It's only one. Let me ask you the question. Do we treat it better? Yes or yes? When we know it's only one of a kind, we're like, oh, be careful. Don't break that. Because if you break it, it's not another one. So why don't we treat ourselves amazing when we're the only one? We're the original. And let me tell you a secret. This is a secret. Y'all hear me? Can y'all hear me? All right, y'all can hear me. This is a secret. So when I started speaking, I was so nervous. I mean, literally, like my legs would buckle. I felt like I was about to fall when I get on stage. Matter of fact, I couldn't even get to the stage because walking to the stage, my legs wouldn't work. So as a speaker in the beginning, I was just so nervous and so scared. Until one day, one of my mentors told me, I said, I'm scared. They said, why are you so nervous? I said, I'm trying to remember everything in my head. I don't have it together. I don't want to mess up. He said, you know, nobody knows what you're about to say, right? I was like, huh? He said, they don't know what you're about to say. So if you mess up, they don't know that you messed up. Only you know you messed up. And I was like, oh, that thing set me free. Because I was like, I forgot point B. He said, nobody even knew it was a point B. I was like, oh, okay. And that made me feel better, right? And I said, okay, if I mess up, nobody knows, right? Listen, guys, you're the original. There's only one like you. Who knows how you're supposed to be? If you mess up, how they know? No, that's how it's supposed to be. How they know you messed up? Because you told them. You're the original, baby. This is how it is. You got to understand. When you have something that's original, you treat it better. When you have something that's a one of a kind, you treat it better. So many of us, the reason why we are not authentic is because we always trying to be somebody else. We always trying, well, if I had a house like the Joneses, if I can keep up with the Joneses, if I had a car like the Joneses, if I had a man like the Joneses, that ain't your journey. I promise you it's not, because if it was, you wouldn't be experiencing it right now. It's not your journey. Things are as they should be. Can you please just stop for a moment and clap and celebrate yourself? Just right now, just celebrate yourself. Only one of a kind, baby. It's only one of a kind. If you break this one, you don't broke the mold, baby. Only one of a kind. Y'all ain't gonna let me be on here celebrate myself by myself. This is a one of a kind situation. Let me tell you something. It might have a few more pounds on it than I like, but hey, my nose might be bigger than I like. My head might be shorter than I like, but I gotta tell you one thing. It's only one of me, baby. Hey, this is the original. Hey, I'm VIP. And guess what? I'm telling you. I'm not asking you. I'm not waiting for you to be in agreement with me. I'm not waiting for you to validate me. I told myself I am VIP. And that's what we gotta do. Number two, what makes you happy?
So,
ever since I was born, I've been trained to serve you.
Yes, I know this, but I would like to know about you. What do you like to do?
Whatever you like.
What kind of music do you like?
Whatever kind of music you like.
Look, I know what I like, and I know you know what I like because you were trained to know what I like, but I would like to know what you like. For instance, do you have a favorite food?
Yes.
Good! What is your favorite food?
Whatever food you like.
Are you saying that no matter what I tell you to do, you will do?
Yes, Your Highness.
Anything I say, you do?
Yes, Your Highness.
Bark like a dog. A big dog.
Woof, 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 woof.
Hop on one leg.
Woof, 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 woof.
Make a noise like an orangutan.
Ah! I see the two of you are getting along.
Excuse me, Maripolo.
Fine girl, isn't she?
Guys, the reason why I showed you that is because most of us don't even know what makes us happy. We don't live all of our lives. Well, what makes you happy? My father said I should get a doctoral degree and then I'll be a good girl. But what makes you happy? Well, my mom said she likes this, so that's what I should do. No. I said, what makes you happy? Oh, my pastor said if I served at church. No. I said, what makes you happy? Well, you know, my mother said I need to get a degree. No. I said, what makes you happy? Do you know how many of us don't even know the answer to that question? You expect to live a prosperous, phenomenal, amazing, glorious life, but you don't even know what makes you happy. Let me tell you something. I knew a woman that loved reggae music just like me. I went to her house one day and I was like, let's play some music. That's back in the days. Y'all may not remember when it was CDs and stuff. And before we had all this Spotify and all this music, I'm still learning. But we used to play CDs. And I said, come on, let's play some reggae music, because we used to play years ago at her house. And she broke down and cried. I said, what's wrong with you? And she said, you know what I didn't realize? 3 years ago, my house was robbed. And they stole all my CDs. And I had not listened to my music in 3 years. And I actually used to play it when I cleaned my house. I actually used to play it when I was happy. When my kids heard me play it, they were like, oh my goodness, mom is happy because we hear that music. That means we could get money from her. We could get everything with that music playing. We haven't had no happy music in this house in 3 years. What makes you happy that you're not doing this week? What makes you happy you haven't done since COVID? Do you even know what makes you happy? Just to let you know, that's a part of the formula. Number three, this is as equally important. What makes you sad? Like, how is that important? Let me tell you, this is probably more important than what makes you happy. You need to let go of what no longer serves you. Now listen, if your feelings become more important than your future, you will lose your future and your feelings will become worse. If there are places that don't bring you joy, why do you go there? If there are people that don't bring you joy, why do you hang out with them? If there's a job that when you go in the building, you feel like you're about to throw up, why do you keep going there? If something makes you sad, and if you don't hear anything else, hear me today on this. Because I'm going to add 10 years to your life as a psychologist. If something makes you sad, you are signaling to your hormonal system. You are signaling to the biochemistry in your body that you are sad, that you are unhappy. And so what happens with your body goes into defense mode. When your body goes into defense mode, it starts to protect you. Your body feels like it is in danger. It starts to protect you. Now, that is something that happens when animals are instinctive and they're out in the jungle and there's another animal about to kill them. Your body gives shoots off this hormone that helps you to withstand whatever is about to happen to you. Please be clear. That is supposed to be for moments, seconds, or minutes. It's not supposed to be for hours. It's not supposed to be for days. It's not supposed to be for months. It's definitely not supposed to be for years. You are cutting off 10 years from your life by constantly signaling to your body, I am unhappy. I am happy. I don't like this place. I don't like this church. I don't like this job. I don't like these people. And your body's like, defense, 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 danger, 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 danger. All right, liver. All right, heart. We're in overtime. We're in overtime. Protector. Danger, 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 danger. And do you think your body can work long like that? It can't. Figure out what makes you sad and stay away from it. Am I saying, so don't visit my mother at the graveyard? No, I'm not talking about stuff like that. I'm talking about you and these toxic relationships that you know don't bring you any joy, and you not cutting them off, and you staying in a relationship with people who don't edify you. You staying in a relationship with people who don't lift you up. You staying in a relationship with people you know when you leave their presence, you are depleted. Every time you leave them, you feel drained. But you still go to see them. What is wrong with you? Let go of what no longer serves you. Number four. Woohoo, get excited. Who's your role model? I want to know, for your formula, who's your role model? So a part of the assignment that you're going to get in your work booklet is that you're going to write down all the attributes of your role model. Who is it in your life that you identify as your role model? And so what I'm going to beg you to do is to be your own superhero. What I'm going to beg you to do is to write down everything, every characteristic, everything that anything that they do that you think is worthy of calling them a role model. Write everything down and then become it. Stop looking outside of yourself. Stop looking outside of yourself. But we need to find this woman, this mentor, this coach. No. Stop looking outside of yourself for somebody to lead you. You lead you. Be your own superhero. Well, I like the way she walked. Well, we'll learn how to walk. Well, I like the way she talked. Well, learn how to talk. Well, I like the way she dressed. Well, mimic the way she dressed. Well, I like the way she handled herself like a boss. Well, practice that. Stop saying this person is great. That person is great. You're great. You're phenomenal. You're amazing. And keep telling yourself until you believe it. Keep telling yourself until you believe it. Number five, know what you're good at. Do you know how many people are so frustrated in this life? I'm going to give you the formula. How many people are frustrated in this life because they're operating in a place that they're not good at? We're all born with these so many talents and so many skills. But everybody's operating outside of their talent and their skill. Look, if you can't cook, You up there cursing your aunt out because she don't like your macaroni and cheese. You want to keep bringing it every year for Thanksgiving. Look, if you can't cook, the best thing you can order is some reservations, okay? That's the best thing, okay? That's the best thing you can make is reservations. Like, stay in your lane. Know what you're good at, right? Understand that everybody has their place. But because so many people are displaced, all the mamas, they out in the jobs working, they hating each other instead of being at home. They gifted, they anointed. We know our children better than anybody. But we out there working for somebody else, putting out kids with somebody else who the people don't love our kids. Everybody is displaced. Everybody go back home. Take care of your own life. Everybody's displaced. Know what you're good at. My daughter, grandmother passed away a couple of weeks ago. We went to the funeral to go support her. The day after that, we had a burial to go to attend. My husband and I got to the burial. We didn't know where, which area of the cemetery ground the family was at. So we went to the main building and we said, excuse me, ma'am, we're looking for the such and such family for the burial. And she's like, excuse me, miss. I was like, uh-huh, excuse me. Yes, may I help you? She said, look, I'm busy. Look, what you want? I was like, we're here for a burial and we're trying to confirm the location. Look, I'm gonna give you this map. You take this map and you figure it out. I was like, yeah, why are you here, girl? I don't like people. I said, let me explain something to you. Number one, it's a people business. Every time a family member dies, people gonna come here. Did you know that? Like, not pets, not animals, like people gonna come here to honor their family member that passed away. And when people come here to honor their family member that passed away, it's a tough time in their life. They grieving because it's new, it's fresh. The person just passed away. So do you think it's probably a good idea to try to be pleasant and cheerful to people? And she kind of dismissed me from her presence. She wouldn't work for me. If you hate people, why are you in the people business? What's wrong with you? Go sit at a computer somewhere. Go in the dark. I don't care where you go. Go on the rock, as far as I'm concerned. She was horrible. So it wasn't my family member. I was there just to hug my child while my child cried on my breast. I was here to hug my baby. It wasn't my death. But what if it was my death? She could have spiraled me into more trauma. It's already a tough time. You're not going to even smile at the people? You're going to throw a paper, a map at them and tell them to figure it out? Are you serious? Please know what you're good at and then go there. If you hate people, why are you at a place where people come in every day and you killing you? You think you're killing them. You're killing yourself. You sold yourself for $20 an hour to make your endocrine system messed up every day. Because every time they come in, you're like, ugh, I hate people. Ugh, I hate people. Your body's like, defense mechanism, danger ahead, danger. You're killing yourself. Go where what you love. Number six. Know what you are bad at. Listen, don't wish you were easy or wish you were better. So many people, they overwhelm themselves because they're not good at certain things. They said, well, you know what? I am Wonder Woman. Hear me roar. I'm going to take care of the baby. I'm going to clean the house. I'm going to fry up the chicken. I'm going to fry it up in the pan and I'm going to bring home the money and I'm going to take care of the family. You know you're overwhelmed. You're trying to balance all the bills in the house and you know you can't even count. I'm talking to myself. Hubby, please take these numbers over. It gives me a headache. You know you're bad at it, but you're like, baby, I'm going to handle this one. You're not good at it. So what takes him 5 minutes takes you 5 hours, but you won't speak up. And you know for sure you're not good at it, but you're always going to try to conquer everything. Let me tell you something. I got a class coming up and it talks about all the hats we wear. And giving us certain life hacks to help with those hacks. Because a lot of the things we do are unnecessary. There are hacks in life where you can delegate out things for no money at all. There are hacks in life where you can actually have a reciprocity system to where you say, okay, say you have a 12-year-old at home, and this is just a random example, and you get frustrated because the floor is not mopped. But you also have a 12-year-old at home who they're a big baby and they just want to play a board game with their mama once a week. What if you say, okay, I got 14 things to do. If you mop this floor on Friday for 1 hour, we'll play checkers. You just got your floor mopped. You just took one thing off your list. I can show you how to do that over and over and over again till you eliminate everything. You also need to know what you are bad at. Number seven, evaluate your friends. Stop hanging around with toxic people. And furthermore, if you have 9 other friends and you're the 10th person and the 9 friends are broke, you're the 10th run. Y'all all do the same things. Y'all go to the same places. It has to be a time in your life where you say, I have to evaluate. Maybe you're toxic. You've been my friend all these years. We ain't never did nothing powerful. We ain't never went on no vacation. We always said we was going to go on vacations. We said we're going to dream big dreams. We still in the same place, sitting around calling each other, being on the phone for 2 hours, complaining about life. You know what? I'm going to do something different in 2022. I'm not here to complain anymore. I'm here to create. So if you want to create with me, let's go. If you don't want to create with me, lose my number. Because my life is going to be different. I love you, sis, but I'm not doing the same thing next year. I'm just not. I'm not staying on the phone complaining about life, complaining about our kids, our man, our money situation. I'm not doing that. I'm just not doing it. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to focus on the 5 areas in my life that I need to develop. If you want to do a 90-day spiritual challenge with me, be my accountability partner. Let's pray together. You want to do a 90-day personal development with me? Okay, let's read the book called The 4 Agreements. This book called The 4 Agreements teaches you about the 4 agreements in life. If you don't know that, you operating backwards. Okay, you want to be my friend? Let's do a 90-day challenge on fitness. Let's walk together for 30 minutes. Okay, you don't live near me, so what? Let's get on FaceTime. Let's be accountable to make sure we're doing it. Let's walk for 30 minutes. If you don't want to create, that's all I'm doing in 2022. I'm 100% focused on creating a better life. I'm not going to live this way. People think they are sad, they're depressed, they're anxious, things that they're overwhelmed, things are not going well. And they think it's because of the things in their life. It's not. It's because of the way they process the things in their life. That's what it is. Number 8, what is your life goal? I'm going to have a whole class on this, guys. What is your assignment, your purpose, your destiny, your passion? If you're not working in a place that you absolutely love, quit your job right now. No, I'm just kidding. I mean, you got to pay the bills, but can you please make it your goal in 2022 to get out of that place that's sucking you dry, that's taking 10 years off of your life, that's telling your body that you're in danger, that keeps telling your liver and your kidney and your heart that you can't work well? Can you please, 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 please tell yourself that? Listen, your life goal is what you came to do. And if nobody ever told you, I'm going to tell you, you're not going to be happy doing anything else. You're just not. You're going to be fake. You're going to be phony. You're going to show up as your not authentic self. Some people like natural hair, but they won't wear their hair natural because they don't think it's socially acceptable. Some people like to do things, but they think somebody else is going to say, what if your assignment is to help the elderly? What if your assignment is to teach young kids how to skateboard? What is your assignment is to teach young boys how to be disciplined? I just want you to know for the rest of your life, the reason why you're depressed, the reason why you have anxiety, the reason why things are not going right is because they will never go right until you go right. The universe is going to keep saying, stop sign, red light, stop sign, red light, stop sign. Go back to your purpose. Your purpose is your assignment. And your assignment is whatever you have a passion for. And if you are not doing that, that's what you were born for. You are an original. And if you don't do it, it's not being done. Only one of you were created. You are the original. You are the unique. You are special. You are VIP. And if you don't do that assignment, the reason why you keep hitting a wall, the reason why you keep hitting blockages, why this brick wall won't move and you praying for God to move your mountain and God is saying, I am sending you a sign to turn left. You are in the wrong place. Wherever I am, there is increase. Wherever I am, I make provision. Do you understand that? And if I'm not there, why are you there in the first place? You must know your assignment, your purpose. Until you figure out what that is and do it every day, you're going to be unsettled. You're going to be anxious. You're going to be depressed. So when would now not be a good time to figure out what that is? I'm going to have a whole class on that. Your formula. Here it is, guys. Y'all ready? Woo! Get excited. Your formula. Here it is. When I say it's easy to do, but it's easier not to do. It's easy to do, but it's easier not to do. I'm going to send you a workbook. I want you to take the time to sit down and to answer every single question in the workbook. And I'm like a college professor. I'm going to tell you what I did at the last minute. I was going to send you guys the workbook earlier, but I didn't want you to have it in front of you because I didn't want you focusing on the workbook and not focusing on yourself. I didn't want you reading ahead. I wanted you to stay with me. Your formula, yielding outstanding, undeniable results in your life. What makes you happy? If you don't know what that is, just take a journal and write it down. What makes you happy? If you're not clear on that, can you please understand that there's no spouse in this world, no lover, no partner that can make you happy? You don't even know what it takes to make you happy. And furthermore, it is irresponsible to put that on someone else to make you happy in the first place. Your formula, what makes you happy minus what makes you sad? Anything that makes you sad, stop doing it today. Today, stop doing it. I don't care if they're your blood and they bring you gossip and they feel. I have a girlfriend. Oh, my Lord. I loved her dearly, but I had to block her. She's like, did you hear about the fire? Did you hear about the rape? Did you hear about the murder? I said, why are you giving me negative news every day? That's why I don't watch the news. Because I don't want to hear all that crap. I don't want it in my vortex. I don't want it in my spirit. I don't want it in my energy. I got a lot to do. I don't like child abuse. I love them babies. Child abuse makes me sad. I don't want to hear about children being abused. Please don't keep telling me that every day. What makes you sad is going to show you your purpose. I don't like child abuse, right? So my purpose is to protect and empower children. There's somebody else that they don't like elderly being abused. Whatever makes you sad is an indication of your purpose. Okay? What makes you happy minus what makes you sad? What makes you sad, we are eliminating that list. Get that list. I don't care if it's Sally, Sue, Bob, and I'm telling you right now, I don't care if it's your church and your pastor. If every day you walk in there, you upset and you sad because you hearing bad news and things not going right, whatever it is, remove yourself. Plus, what you are good at? What are you good at? Why are you out of your lane? Why are you the baddest cook on the planet, but you over here trying to do something else? Well, you know, I'm just a mother, and I don't think cooking is a passionate thing. I think I should go learn how to be one of those people that count numbers and, you know, one of those people that do taxes. And, you know, I said, you don't even know it's called an accountant. I don't think that's your gift, girl. I just don't think that's your gift. Just know what you're good at. And see, you know, let me tell you what everybody does. They know what makes them happy. For me, I like candles. I like reading books. I like swimming. You know what makes you happy, but you never do it. I like going out in nature. You never do it. You know what makes you sad, but you're always there. You're always around the people that make you unhappy. I don't like people that bully people, but this girl, she got a sharp tongue. And I don't like people that bully people. She always seems angry. Why are you around her? Why? Plus, what you're good at? Find out your skills, your natural abilities. Develop that. Get real good at that. Then also know what you're bad at. Also know what you suck at. Know that it's certain things you just don't do well. Like I said, if you can't cook, the best thing you can make for me is a reservation. You know what I'm saying? Like, know what you suck at and stop trying to do it. See, so you're going to make the macaroni and cheese for Thanksgiving, even though they said it's horrible. Then you're going to go to your family house. Then you piss with everybody in the plate because nobody won't eat your macaroni and cheese. Everybody else got food ate except for yours. And now you're going home with feels. But you know what your gift is? Edifying people, lifting them up. You're really a comedian. You make people laugh. So instead of you going to Thanksgiving saying, oh, I got some new jokes this year. We've been through a lot during COVID. I'm going to make my family laugh. You're a great singer. You like, I'm bringing a speaker. We're doing karaoke today. Bring your joy. Don't try to get out of your lane and then get mad because people don't receive you. You suck. Stop it. Find out what you're good at. And then as soon as you find out what you're good at, you are going to find your life's purpose. This is your formula. Y'all should be going crazy right now. I just gave you gold, yielding, outstanding, undeniable results. What if you did every day what makes you happy and you got paid for it? What if you never went to a place or been around people that makes you sad? Am I saying that life, look, this is a disclaimer. Life ain't gonna stop. I'm telling you right now, life gonna still keep happening. We still gonna have difficulties and challenges. But wouldn't it be nice if we stop putting ourselves in the difficulties and challenges every day? You gonna hang around Debbie the Downer and she wanna give you gossip? Every time I see one family member, their job is to catch me up. Oh, did you hear? You know, Bobby's daughter, she's 16. You know she's pregnant. And did you know them two broke up? They try to act like they all that. We knew they wasn't that tight. They broke up. Did you know this? Shut up. If you're not here to elevate, if you're not here to increase me, I don't want to hear that. What's going on good? If you ain't got nothing good to say, shut up. And I mean that. Not be quiet. Shut up. I'm not your trash can. Go listen to somebody else that want to hear that crap. I don't want to hear that. I know my assignment. My assignment is to uplift. My assignment is to empower. And you are stealing from me. You are stealing my energy by giving me all this trash and I don't want it. Take it back. Return to sender. I am on my purpose. And until you find yours, stay away from me. I am on my purpose. And look, you're going to find your life's purpose. What makes you happy minus what makes you sad plus what you're good at minus what you suck at. Guess what? You're going to find your life's purpose. Let me tell you, my daughter, my goddaughter, she loves to do hair and makeup, right? Now, when this girl was 8 years old, I should have known what her gift was. When this girl was 8 years old, we'll be out at the market. We'll be a giant market. And she be like, oh, my God, why your hair look like that? I was like, you can't say that to people. You can't say that. She was like, you want me to fix that for you? Like, as a child, she was obsessed with people's hair being out of place. And then it turns out she had the gift to be the baddest hair. You know, look, what makes you happy? What are you good at? It will reveal your life's purpose. And here's another secret. Your life's purpose will pay you. Your life's purpose will pay you when you're in the right place at the right time. You will show up as your authentic self. Do you know that people know when you're phony? Do you know that people know when you hate dealing with people? That lady couldn't hide that she hated dealing with people. I knew she didn't have to say I hate people. I knew that by the way she said hello to me. You ain't hiding nothing. Your life ain't no secret. You think, well, they don't see me eating these potato chips. We see it. We see the weight. Like, your life ain't no secret. I'm telling you now. You don't have integrity in your life. A bad karma is coming to you. Your life is no secret. Your life's purpose will make you a blissful, peaceful, happy you. Let me tell you, this formula looks simple, and most people won't sit down and say, what actually makes me happy? I don't want to cry. I'm 52 years old. I don't know what makes me happy. Don't cry. Wipe your tears. We've been through a lot now, but figure it out. And it may change over time. It may evolve. It may grow. But please know what that is. And please give that to yourself. If you have the most peace when you're in water by yourself, no kids, no husband, nobody. I love to swim. Then go swim. I bought myself a membership to go swim at the Y. I bought myself a Wonder Woman bathing suit. And I get so excited on swim days. I get so excited. I'm like, oh my God. Because when I was 330 pounds and I would get in the water, I felt weightless. I didn't feel big no more. It was my happy place. I could just lay on my back and swim. And I'm like, man, I can't run, but I could swim though. It was my happy place. What do you guys have your happy place and you haven't been there in a year? What do you think you're doing to yourself? You're going to find your purpose. In conclusion, you have made it to the end of the masterclass. And I have a gift for you guys. In conclusion, be original. Stay true to yourself. You'll never be more happy. everybody is, you know, displaced. I love to cook, but I'm painting. I love to paint, but I'm driving. I love to drive, but I'm packing stuff. I love to pack, but I'm teaching. I really love to teach, but I like just everybody go back to their proper place and make the world a better place, Jesus. You are allowed to be both a masterpiece and a work in progress at the same time. You are allowed to be a masterpiece and a work in progress at the same time. And a good place for you to start is with the book called The Four Agreements. And it is by Don Miguel Ruiz. It's DonMiguelRuiz, I think. I'm looking at my name. Don Miguel, The Four Agreements. And this is the other thing. Say you're not proud of yourself right now. You're not proud of some of the things you've done. You know you can reinvent yourself anytime you want. You can say, yesterday, I didn't pray the way I wanted to. I'm going to start tomorrow. Yesterday, I didn't work out the way I wanted to. I'm going to start tomorrow or right now. You know what? My relationships have been a bit toxic. And I think that is because I can't give what I don't have to give. You know, if you want a friend, you got to first show yourself friendly. And sometimes we got to look ourselves in the mirror and say, wow, I only could give what I have. I'm not very generous, not very sweet and kind, kind of bully myself, haven't been good to myself. But I think this is a good time to start every day loving myself and looking myself in the mirror and say, baby girl, I know up to this point of the movie, it hasn't really been what you thought it was going to be, but can we make the rest of our life the best of our life? Can we please show up for ourselves? Can we say, look, all right, this happened, that happened, this happened. Can we stop blaming our partners, our parents, our churches? Can we stop blaming today and say, I'm reinventing myself. I'm going to be what I look out for others in. I'm going to be my own superhero, me. I'm not waiting for nobody to validate me. I'm not waiting for nobody to celebrate me. I'm gonna do that for myself. And if you don't like the way I show up, that's your business. I ain't got nothing to do with me. Point blank, period. So listen, guys, jump and the wings will appear. Look, you don't have to be great to start, but you have to start to be great, people. I know it feels tough and you're like, so you're telling me that I'm just going to be this happy person? I promise you, if you do what you love and you stop doing what you don't love, I promise you that's all it takes. But can you imagine going to a job every day that you hate, being around people every day that you hate, coming home to relationships with people you don't have a good relationship with because you never learned effective communication because that's what you learned from your parents? Can you imagine looking yourself in the mirror every day and having insecurities about yourself? Can you imagine always wearing big clothes because you don't want nobody to see your roles? Can you imagine never showing up for yourself? Can you imagine never eating right? Can you imagine doing everything wrong every day in your life and you think your life is just going to magic? One day have $1 million in your account and you just start skipping down the street as a skinny, beautiful, amazing. No! Jump! The wings will appear, I promise you. Tell yourself, baby girl, you're worth it. I know you've been through a lot. I know we are traumatized, but today starts now. And always seems impossible until it's done. I thank you guys for attending and I appreciate you guys. I hope you enjoyed today. Just stay for the last 5 minutes because I have some gifts for each and every one of you. And I just want you to know that, okay, I always get choked up at the end. I just want you to know that this is my dream. Showing up, giving my heart right now. My bleeding and what I've been through has become a blessing. My test has become a testimony. My mess has become my message. And I no longer tell myself, you can't talk to the people. You don't have the right size. I no longer tell myself, you can't speak. I no longer tell myself, guess what? I'm just going to jump. I've seen master classes with millions of people there. I got a few, but that's okay. I'm going to jump. The wings will appear. Promise you, they will appear. And guess what? If not one person sign up, if not one person show up, I ain't by myself. How you think I got them wings in the first place? He's with me. How you think I got them wings? Man, stretch yourself. Do something you said you couldn't do. What you can't do, you must do. What you can't do, you must do. What you can't do, you must do. Do something you're afraid of. Show up for yourself. Remind yourself that you are great and stop putting the greatness in others and put it back to you. So thank you guys for attending. Thank you guys for being the beginning of my dream. Stay tuned for 2022. The revolution will not be televised, but I promise you, you're going to see some stuff and I'm excited. Now, don't miss the next masterclass. It is on December the 11th. If you want to save the date, I will be posting this online and I will be sending you guys an email invite as well as a text invite. And the next time we're going to talk about a class that really changed my life that I attended. And it's called Values, the Success Blueprint. And it just talks about our values. And it talks about how so many people on their deathbed, they said, man, I wouldn't have worked all day and all night like I did if I knew I was going to get this money, but my values was off. I wouldn't have tried to have the big house. I wouldn't have chased that man. I wouldn't have chased that woman. My values were off. Everybody has a success blueprint for their own values. And if you are not aligned with that, you'll never be happy. If you're not aligned with your values, you'll live a fake life. You'll live a fraud life. But that's the next class. And I hope each and every one of you will join me. So here are my little commercials. We talked about the five areas that you have to get in place. Spiritual development, personal development, physical development, financial development, and relational development. Now, I'm a person, I'm an action person. It's okay to talk about it. It's okay to talk about it, but it has to come to a point where we have to apply some action behind it. So if you don't have no way to develop yourself spiritually, I welcome you to my church, Living Word South, with my pastor, Prophetess Deborah Jones. We go live on Sunday mornings. We have virtual service at 10:30 a.m. If you do not have a church home, I welcome you to check us out. I welcome you to say, I am spiritually going to become fit. I don't know how I'm going to do it. I don't even know where I'm going to do it, but I'm going to start somewhere. So here's the start. If you don't have one, I wanted to give you an alternative. Number two, financial development. Listen, Middleton and Cornish Associates, she is a money coach. And you can screenshot this and I'll also be sending this to you. She has a free gift for you today. Everybody get excited. Now, I sat with her. She's a money coach. And what she does is she teaches people free financial education. She teaches you income protection. During COVID, so many things happened to so many people and their money were off, right? Life insurance, investing, budgeting. She is the money coach. She's also a speaker. She will also come to your home, to your family, your friends. But this is the thing that I love. She said, look, Dr. J, sit down with me. And I said, now is not a good time. I'm restructuring my business. I had to close my business for COVID. I said, I'll get back with you. I said, let's get together around February. She was like, no, we're getting together now. We got together and guess what? She showed me, I said, so you telling me y'all had programs where there's no money and this and that, and you can get this $100,000 worth of coverage income. I never knew anything like this ever existed. And she says, download this app. When you download this app, they're going to put $50 in your account. I was like, what? I was like, what? She's like, I can show you. Just pay attention. So if I were you, I would text your name and free gift to 410-294-3702. She's going to make an appointment with you. And she's the money coach. She can show you how to make a dollar holla. This woman is bad to the bone, and she's thorough and excellent. So if anybody needs a free gift like I did, and I was thankful, anybody need a free gift, text your name and free gift to Middleton Cornish and Associates. Is anybody doing it? Raise your hand if you get your free gift today. All right. Next.
Speak that number.
Uh-oh, go back. The number is 410-294-3702. And if you're getting your free gift from the Money Coach, put in the chat, Money Coach, I'm getting my free gift. Money Coach, 410-294-3702. I will be sending you this as well. So keep her name. Next, text your name to, now this young lady right here, oh my Lord, Miss Felicia Vice. She's a senior sales director with Mary Kay. Book your call. She has listened late. Now, ladies, y'all better pay attention to this. She has a complimentary skin evaluation, and she enters you in a monthly drawing. So when she comes out, now let me tell you this. Now everybody has a gift. My gift ain't no makeup. I ain't never in my life seen somebody excited about lipstick. This woman is excited about makeup. But what she told me was that this is a ministry for her because so many women don't feel pretty. So many women don't feel beautiful. And when she shows them how to make themselves glow, she feels like it's a ministry in elevating their self-esteem. I thought it was just lip gloss and some foundation. She said, no. Beauty is skin deep, my dear. So her name is Felicia Vice, and she wants to give you a free complimentary skin evaluation. So text your name. And this is the other thing, ladies. We've all been stuck in the house for COVID. Wouldn't it be so nice? You host a little party and you get your friends to come over and everybody gets a free skin evaluation. You get to hang out with each other. And you just gave all of your, maybe three of your closest friends, you haven't seen them in a while. You get to kill two birds with one stone. You get to have community. You get to have fellowship. You get to give them a free gift and you get a free gift. What makes you happy? What have you done to just enjoy yourself one day? What have you done just to laugh? What have you done just to play? What makes you happy? Get excited. Look. Okay, so let me get my spill. Sandra Whitley has this amazing, phenomenal products. Listen, this is so amazing and awesome and wonderful. Now, these drops ain't no joke. And let me tell you how I know these drops ain't no joke. I'm not just telling you these drops ain't no joke. These drops ain't no joke at all. You put these drops under your tongue. Now, you text oil to 443-985-0102. She's going to give you an evaluation and she's going to show you. She has organic, natural products to help your health. How are we going to get our health together if we don't focus on our health? We have to focus on our health. She will literally take time out of her day to find out what are you hurting? Where are you hurting? What are you lacking in? I can help you. And it's organic. She will take time out of her day to make sure that you get these things. So text oil to 443-985-0102. Also, if you're trying to lose weight, and this complements what Sandra Whitley has, they have this detox tea where you can lose 5 pounds in 5 days. Get excited. Go in the chat if you are texting Sandra Whitley. Go in the chat and write oil. Go in the chat if you're hitting up Mary Kay and say, look, my girlfriends, I don't care if it's three of us. We're getting together. We're getting our skin evaluated. We know we want to look brighter. You know why you don't look brighter? Because you're rehearsing your danger and your sadness every day. You better remove yourself from that. Lose 5 pounds in 5 days. If you text T, look at all this free stuff you're getting. You just got a free complimentary facial. You got a free evaluation to get some organic supplements. You got a free money coaching session. And now you're going to get some free samples to have vitamins and everything in your life. This is amazing. Also, if we're going to start moving, guess what? You can have a virtual fitness session. This guy is in Atlanta, Georgia, and he is gifted with transforming our bodies. You can text Maniac to 856-425-9. Uh-oh, that's not the right number. Okay, get excited. But there's his IG. You can text Anybody want his number, text it to me, put it in the chat. But this is what I want you guys to know. We have to be intentional, absolutely intentional about getting our lives in order. Class is over, but I want to leave you guys with this. I thank you for attending today. These are all my handles. Every handle I have is Dr. Monifa Jones, IG, Facebook, TikTok, YouTube. My email is drmonifajones@gmail.com. So for my next class on December the 11th, what I'm going to do, and I don't even know if it's covered up by the people's names on the side because mine's is covered up. I'm working with these two ladies from Ireland. I got to tell you guys, I'm so excited. I know 2022, I'll be busting seven figures. I'm working with these two ladies from Ireland who are and if you want to know about this, you can ask me. I'll tell you free of charge. I'm in a class. They create funnels for you where they go online. And they actually find your avatar, which is your business target market, and they put your product in front of them and have people purchase it. I have classes, I have seminars that I have done. They said, Dr. J, you have the it factor. I'm gonna put you in front of a million people and I promise you 10,000 will buy it overnight. They said, however, that's cute, you're $49.99. But no, we charge them $499.99 because we know you have what it takes. We know there are people around the world that need this information. And we also know they will pay for it. We know there are people who stuck, who wish they could have better relationships with their children. I have a series on relationships with your family, with your children. They said people are stuck. They will pay millions. They will pay tens of thousands. We're going to make them pay $499.99 for your stuff. But I'm committed to you guys because guess what? You're part of the beginning. I'm committed to you guys that I told the class last time, if you commit to coming to my class, and my class is $49.99, for the first class, I had a two-for-one special. The two-for-one special was $49.99. You could bring two people. That was my special. All my other classes are $49.99. And if you think it's worth it, say it is worth it. Hey, if you pay, you pay attention. You know how many people won't spend $50 on themselves? But I tell them go buy a dress that they'll never wear. I tell them go to a party where they get drunk. They'll do that. But I say spend $50 on yourself. They wouldn't do it. But if you pay today and today only for the next class, I'm only charging you $20. And what's that for? I don't know. But I'll be thankful, of course. But I'm only charging you $20. I don't know if you guys can see it. It looks like it's behind the people's names. Can you guys see the screen with the Cash App? Okay. So text me if you need to text me for anything. I want you guys to know that I love and appreciate you. And we are at the end. And I want to say again, my final word to you is jump and the wings will appear. Thank you for attending. I thank each and every one of you. Thank you. I hope you found value. Please look out. If anybody wants to unmute themselves, you're welcome. Please look out for your email and do your homework.
Yes. Awesome, it's Dr. Amazing, Dr. Mo. OMG, I'm so proud of you. This was absolutely amazing.
It was amazing. I agree.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so
love
much.
You, Doc.
Thank you guys. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Can't wait to the next one. Woo!
Yes, this was so great. Thank you so much.
I'm so
all the way from North Carolina. Thank you.
New York. I'm telling you guys, whatever you're good at, just do it. Whatever you're good at, go do it. Do it tomorrow. Don't wait. Don't wait. Guess what? The world is waiting for you. They waiting. Don't be selfish. You know you love to do it. You know you love it. Go do it. Go do it. I love each and every one of you that's sown into my life. I speak back forth your life, a manifestation of blessing. It's only the beginning. It's up from here. And I thank you for your participation. And I will be sending you, do your homework. You're going to do your homework.
Definitely.
All right, do your homework. Love you.
Thank you, Queen.
Have a great day.